ओम अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनाशलाकया चक्षुरोन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। नमः ओम विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामीनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सरस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणी। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे रामा राम रामा। Gives me great pleasure to be with all of you speaking on this very important topic of five secrets of lasting relationships. Actually, there are so many ships in this world that will never sink. And when the Americans, they tried to make the best ship, they said the Titanic is a ship that even God cannot sink. And very interestingly, the Titanic sank on its first voyage from England. It never reached America. And similarly, all of us, we always want that our relationship should never sink. And the most interesting thing is, if we are not really ready, if we are not really careful, then our relationship is like the Titanic ship, which we don't want to sink. But then there are a lot of possibilities, a lot of chances that it sinks. So we have to be very careful with our relationship. Actually, in our lives, we all want this. We want very nice, happy relationships. We get a good partner. We have good kids. Our friends are very nice. And everything in our life should be very nice. But often what we get is this. Usually there's a lot of screaming, a lot of shouting. There's a lot of misunderstanding in our lives. And we don't know many times how to react. So many times, you know, it's not just two people talking, but there is an interaction of feelings. So usually one person is saying, you don't respect me, you're selfish. This is your problem. And what about me? This is not my fault. Stop nagging, take responsibility. I already told you. And this is how you always are. You always say that. I am right. So these are these different words that are there on the screen. And the other person is also not going to keep quiet. This person says, is that so? Stop being so selfish. Grow up. You are pathetic. So when two people are talking to each other, more than two personalities talking to each other, I would say it is a two bundle of emotions talking to each other. After first few hours, after first few days, for some people it could be after the first few months. But after that, you know, the beauty of the face is not very important. And all the other externals, they are no longer that important. What affects the quality of the relationship is basically the emotional connect. Are these two personalities able to connect to each other? And as long as there is screaming and shouting, one interesting thing is, when you see somebody very close to you, increasing the volume, you should understand the only need to increase one's volume of speech is when the distance between two people is increased. So sometimes it happens that two people are standing close to each other, very next to each other, but the volume of one of those people will increase. It means you should understand there is a perception of increase in distance between us, and that is why this person is trying to compensate for the increase in distance by increasing the volume. So the first thing that all of us can remember is when anybody around us raises a volume and that person is very close to us, instead of we raising our volume, instead of we again retaliating and shouting, we keep quiet and we try to reduce the distance that has come between these two people, because of which that person is increasing his or her volume. You know, one of my friends was sharing how when you go to a traffic signal and you see a red light, that red light is something that does not depress you. That red light, obviously, you know, you want to go straight. You want to reach your destination fast. But when you see that red light, you stop, you take some rest. You're driving, your hand is at the steering wheel. If you're in a two-wheeler, you're driving. So it hurts sometimes after a long drive. So when there is a red signal, instead of trying to look at the red signal as something that is stopping your journey, you can take that time as a rest time. Slow down, take a few breaths, become fresh, and very soon that red signal in front of your eyes will again turn into a green signal. And when it turns into a green signal, are you fresh? Have you overcome your fatigue? Have you overcome your tiredness when the red signal was there? So those of us who do not accept the red signal for what it is, we are angry at the red signal and we don't take rest. Our hands don't take a rest. We don't take a few breaths of fresh air when there is red signal. And then tomorrow, when the red signal turns into a green signal, actually we are more tired than before and we cannot take advantage of the green signal. So in life, if you see, everything that you do is receiving a red signal. Actually, it is a signal from God telling you there's a long journey behind because of which you are tired, and there's a long journey ahead which requires a lot of energy. So be fresh, take some rest. So intelligent people take advantage of the red signal. They don't get angry at the red signal. And that's why in a relationship also sometimes when the volume is increasing, we don't increase our volume, we keep quiet. Let the whole volume go down, reduce the distance, and then again start talking in a soft voice. So many of us might wonder, why can't we always have sweet, nice, dependable, trustworthy relationships? Why do relationships always have to end in shouting and screaming and like that? So I want to tell you of one place where there are no arguments and fights. Yes, there is one place where there are no arguments and fights. Any idea from anybody which place this is? Anybody would like to volunteer? You can unmute yourself and talk.
Maybe grave.
Okay, nice. I thought you will say a temple because you know you see me in saffron clothes. Mandirat bhandna nahi ho. Okay, that's nice to hear from you. Yes. So one place where there are no fights is, you know, usually in all cities, even in Baramati, there is this Mukti Dham. You know, we assume that anybody whose body is burned there, he goes back. So we call it Mukti Dham. So Mukti Dham is a place where there are no fights. One time in my family, you know, when one senior person, he went away. And when he was there in this world, there used to be so much fighting. He had some strong opinions about something. So I saw when he left and we were all there at the Mukti Dham, then everyone just kept quiet and nobody was fighting. And 3 days later, again, fighting started. But this is only one place where there is no fighting. Okay, another situation where there is no fighting. Another situation where there is no fighting is, this is that situation. It takes some time for the screen to change. Just hold on for some time. Okay, on the screen is a brick wall. Is my voice audible?
Yes, Prabhuji.
Okay, yes, video is also video? Yeah, okay. So this is also another place where there is no argument because these two bricks, they never talk with each other. They don't argue with each other. They don't fight with each other. They don't express their opinion. There's no disagreement of opinion. So two places where fights don't take place, when two dead objects are close to each other, and another is when two living people, they are with each other in Mukti Dham. At every other place in this world, there are bound to be arguments, there are bound to be differences of opinion. So everywhere else in this world, there will be some differences of opinion. There will be always some ups and always some downs. So it is said, you know, all of your medicos, and you can understand this, that an ECG graph, when it goes up and down, actually it's a very healthy sign. So it is very difficult for all of us to accept this because we are now trying to be idealistic आपल्यामध्ये एक थोडासा कल आलाय आता आधुनिक जगामध्ये की आपण खूप आदर्शवादी व्हायचा प्रयत्न करतोय. पण साधारणतः इफ यू जस्ट अंडरस्टँड दिस, लाईफ मीन्स अप्स अँड डाऊन्स. वेन अ पर्सन इज अलाइव, द ईसीजी ग्राफ गोज अप अँड डाऊन. अँड वॉट इफ दिस ईसीजी ग्राफ गोज फ्लॅट? दॅट इज अ हॉरिफाईंग सिच्युएशन. पीपल विल स्टार्ट क्राईंग, पीपल विल स्टार्ट स्क्रीमिंग, डॉक्टर डॉक्टर सेव्ह मी. सिमिलरली इन एनी रिलेशनशिप, इफ देर आर नो अप्स अँड डाऊन्स, आय कॅन टेल यू फॉर शुअर, assume very safely that this relationship is more or less dead. So many times, you know, if in a marriage relationship there is no emotions for each other, then the husband will come on time, whatever is fed to him he will accept it, and whatever is happening at home he will say, okay, very nice, very nice. And some family members might assume that everything is going good. Actually, that person has lost interest in the family because of something. It could be financial problem, it could be social problem, whatever. It could be health problem also. But a normal family man, when he comes home, he will give some opinion. He will say, why is this like this? Why this person is behaving like this? There has to be some opinion. Why? Because you are a living person. You like something, you don't like something, you prefer something, you don't prefer something. So whenever people express their opinions, we should never take it as people are countering us, people are attacking us, people are disagreeing with us. It is just a need of a live human being to express his or her opinion. Recently, you know, one person I know, you know, there was some discussion going on, and this person expressed opinion, and then I replied to it. I said, well, this is how it is, what can be done? And that person replied, I was not expecting any reply. I just informed you that this is something that I was thinking. And then I realized that sometimes people just want to let you know that this is what is going on. They may not even expect a reply from you. So in this way, we should understand that when people express, and when sometimes in that expression of their opinion, there is disagreement, sometimes there's agreement, it is a good sign. It is a good sign of the relationship health. And if there are no opinions expressed, then we should call the doctor. We should call a relationship doctor. So we need to be very careful. Ups and downs in our life, they indicate that the relationship is still alive. Ups and downs on the ECG graph, they indicate that the person is still alive. So some tips for making relationships last. Some tip number one is that I accept differences. There might be differences between me and the other person. So on the screen is a cylindrical object. And when you look at that object from one side, then the shadow that is formed is a circular shadow. And when you look at that object from another side, then the shadow that is formed is a square shadow. So imagine two people who are at two different ends. And based on the shadow or based on what they are seeing, they'll argue with each other. The object in front of me is a circle. And one another person will say, the object in front of me is a square. Now, both of them are completely correct. But from their own perspective, the position from which they are looking at the object. So on the screen, you can see it is written, this is true. On another side also, it is written, this is true. And then at the bottom it is written, this is the truth. So one thing is the objective truth, the real truth. And then there are relative truths. There was one person who was walking and he was limping. Latskat latskat chalat hota. And there were four doctors watching the show. One was a neurologist. One was an orthopedician, one was a general practitioner, and one was a radiologist. So the general practitioner mentioned, maybe, you know, he needs some energy booster. Maybe he's not having high energy in his body right now. Maybe vitamin D deficiency. The orthopedic said, by looking at the movement, it seems there is some bone in his heel that is not really proper. Maybe it needs some surgery. And the radiologist said, well, you know, basically this calls for an x-ray. And the neurologist said, some of the nerves on the side, maybe the sciatica or something like that, he said, is not functioning properly. And they said, let us check with the person. And they asked the person, why are you limping like this? He said, actually, my chappal is broken. That's why I'm like this. So all these four people, you know, from their own individual perspectives, they're looking at something that is far away. And from their own perspective, it all looks very different. But when there is a truth, and then there is a relative truth. So in our lives also, what we think is, I saw it. Sometimes in an argument, sometimes when you're fighting with somebody, you say, Are mi swatacha doyanni baghitla. Mi swata baghitla. Or sometimes, you know, somebody is speaking on the phone and then you heard something. And then you say, now I know what is there in that person's heart. Mi swatacha kananni aikla te. But I can tell you so many times, there have been so many instances where, you know, people have misunderstood somebody else's words and somebody has been misjudged. One of our friends in the ashram, one time they were on the way to some yatra and they were in a bus. And when they were in that bus, just a minute. When they were traveling, there was some opinion that we should have some kirtan. And what this friend of mine has a good voice, so he started singing. And then there was a need for playing tar, kartal. So there was a devotee next to him, and you know, this devotee who was singing, he gave that tar, he gave that kartal to that person. And he said, you play kartal, I'm singing. And that person, he did not play kartal. So 2 minutes, 3 minutes, this friend of mine, he waited, and then he really became angry. Why is this person not playing kartal? And then he looked at him in very strong look, anger in his eyes. And 5 minutes later, he's still not playing kartal. So he got so angry, he took that kartal and gave it to somebody else to play. And that person started playing. And then for the rest of the day, this person was looking angrily at this person who did not play kartal. And then after some time, you know, there was this chadar on his, there's some shawl on his shoulders. And that chadar fell down. And then there was no hands to this person who was traveling in the yatra. So this friend of mine was telling me, this was the first time I judged somebody. And this is the last time I will ever judge anybody in my life. So these kind of experiences have happened where people thought, majha doyanni mi baghitla ki tyani kartal nahi vajavle, pan ka nahi vajavle, jeva ti shawl khali padli teva baghitla ki tyala hatach navhte. There was some accident some days back, and even though there was an accident and this person had been hospitalized, still out of his affection, he still managed to come for the yatra. So sometimes, you know, we know somebody for 10 years, but we may be out of touch in the last 1 month or 2 months, and a lot of things happen. The world is not a very nice place any longer. And we don't know what somebody is undergoing in their own lives. Just recently, one family that I know, you know, their son, he entered the 12th standard and he was studying, but he was getting caught up in a smartphone. And the father told him one day that you cannot spend so much time on the smartphone. And the son felt really offended by this. And just 2 weeks back, this incident has happened, that this 11th standard boy who just now entered 12th standard, because his father scolded him for spending so much time on the cell phone, he has ended his life. Now, if I see those parents and if I don't know what they're undergoing in their life, it will be very difficult for me to treat them differently. So my point is, lot of things are happening and there are different perspectives. So we don't know what is happening, and that's why we should be very careful. There is this childhood story that I had heard. You know, there was this elephant which came, and the six people, they had never seen an elephant and they were blind. So they went to the elephant and they started touching. So somebody is touching the tusk of the elephant and he's saying, elephant is like an arrow. Somebody is saying, elephant is like a snake. Somebody is saying, elephant is like a wall. Somebody is saying, elephant is like a tree trunk. And somebody is saying, elephant is like a snake or a rope. So all these six people, in their own limited way, they are speaking the truth. But because we have eyes, we can see. The elephant is definitely partly a snake, partly a wall, partly a tree trunk, and an elephant is much more. So always remember that when two people come together in a relationship, the kind of experiences that they have undergone in their previous days may be very different. And that's why we should understand that there will always be differences of opinion. Wherever two or more people come together, there will always be differences of opinion. We can have three responses for these differences of opinion. There are three ways in which we can look at this. First is that we can totally shun this diversity. We can totally deny this diversity. How can there be differences of opinion? I don't accept differences of opinion. Second thing is, well, what to do? This person seems to be very different. And second option is that we somehow or other tolerate this diversity. We don't accept it. And there can be a third way of dealing with this. So on the screen right now is a variety of different curries. And some, I can see some moong dal, I can see some tur dal, I can see some plain dal, I can see some matki, I can see some, a lot of other curries are there. Now, out of all these curries, if you like one particular curry, Marathi lokanna generally kadhi pan khup avadte, takachi kadhi banavtat. So one day, you know, at your home, kadhi is served. You say, wow, such nice kadhi, I really like this kadhi. Next day, you come home from OPD, tired, and the same kadhi is offered to you. So, are wah, maja ali. Kal pan sandhyakali kadhi hoti, aaj pan sandhyakali kadhi hai, khup chhan, maja ali, garam garam kadhi, paus padto hai. Parak tisra divshi, again it is kadhi. The third time, your experience of kadhi goes down. Fourth day, again it is kadhi. Seventh day, you will say, aplyakade kai daal, kai bhaji, kai kadhanya ahe ka ghari, roz roz kadhi ka banota hai. Then, you know, the other person will say, well, you said you like kadhi and you were so happy that whenever I gave you kadhi, you were so happy. That's what I mean. Say, ekda donda yogya vatta, sa divas, dupar, sandhyakal, jeva kadhi, kadhi, kadhi asel, kantale to, vite to tesa. So now for the next 2 months, please don't make kadhi. And the person who made kadhi for you out of love will think, what happened to you? You only said kadhi is very good. That's why I made it. And now you are saying, pudcha don mahine nahi karaycha. So then one another principle comes up. Yes, I like kadhi. But I also would like to have a variety. Tich tich goshta varamvar keli ta avadat nahi. Ganyamadhe raag astat. Toch ekach raag jar purna ganyat asla, purna eka bhajanat asla, ta te ayogya vatta. Pan tya bhajanamadhe pan variety paije, raganamadhe variety paije. Jari cinema sarva ekach theme var astat, ek prem prakaran astat. Sadharan eka cinema madhe prem prakaran astat. Pan tya prem prakaranamadhe kay kay te variety detat. कधी मुलीचा भाऊ विरुद्ध असतो, कधी मुलाचे वडील विरुद्ध असतात, मग कधी हेच प्रॉब्लेम, कधी तोच प्रॉब्लेम. ओव्हरऑल इफ यू सी ऑल सिनेमाज हॅव जस्ट वन थीम, इट्स अ लव्ह स्टोरी, दॅट इज व्हॉट सेल्स. बट देर आर सो मेनी व्हरायटीज इन दॅट, अँड दॅट्स व्हॉट मेक्स मूवीज पॉप्युलर. इफ यू हॅव द सेम मूवी अँड द सेम काइंड ऑफ सिच्युएशन अँड द सेम रेझिस्टन्स, इट वॉन्ट वर्क. सो व्हरायटी इज द स्पाइस ऑफ लाईफ. अँड ऑन द स्क्रीन राईट नाव आर डिफरंट फ्रुट्स, देर आर सम स्पाइसेस ऑल्सो आय कॅन सी. So the, if there are varieties of spices, then that is what gives taste to our food. Rozat zar mirchi asel, ani rozat zar god asel, it will be a difficult thing. Similarly, there are varieties of fruits. Some are juicy fruits, and some are dry fruits, and some are different, you know, reddish fruits and green fruits and kiwi and this and that. So all these fruits, they're variety and we like them. Now, I'm going to show you something. So on the screen is, there are four vases. There is a vase in which there are some pink colored flowers, and there is a vase in which there are some blue colored flowers, and then there is a vase in which there are red roses, and then there are some pink roses, and in the center there is a vase in which there is a mixture of roses. So the question for all of you is, which vase looks the most beautiful? Anybody would like to volunteer?
Mixed one.
The center one, yes? Although yes. The other four are also very beautiful, but you know, when you have a variety, the red color, the green color, the violet color, and the pink color, it looks really beautiful. So, one interesting thing is, for food, we want variety. For movies, we want variety. For going for picnics, we want variety. Someday we'll go to Mahabaleshwar, sometimes we'll go to some another place, and you know, sometimes will go to North India, sometimes we'll go to South India. So we can shun it, we can tolerate it, and the third option we have is we can consider it a fortune that in my family, in my friend circle, in my association of friends, or in the medicos guild in Baramati, there's a variety of people. There are somebody who are music oriented, there are somebody who are relationship oriented, there are some people who are very efficient. If you want to organize a function, then there must be some doctors there. You tell them that this function has to be organized and everything will be taken care of. There must be somebody who's very interested in food. And if you tell him to manage the food, you can be assured that the food will be very nice food. So in this way, we can understand pratyek veles pratyek vyakti jar aplya matashi milta julta asel tar kadachit aplya manala nehmi samadhan milel, but kadachit it may not be a very nice relationship and it may not be a very healthy relationship. So sometimes there can be a family in which there are no disagreements. The husband agrees with the wife, and the wife agrees with the child, and the child agrees with the husband. So sometimes, if there are no disagreements, we have to re-examine whether we are living people or we are just a family of mechanical robots staying together. One very excellent example from the scriptures that I can think of is the picture on the screen. So Yudhishthir is very much dharma oriented. He is always evaluating things in terms of right and wrong. Bhim is somebody who is saying, don't think so much, just do it. Arjun is somebody who is always thinking about whether it will please Krishna. It may be right, it may be wrong, but finally it has to please Krishna. Nakul and Sahadev, they are very obedient. They will say, whatever Yudhishthir says, whatever Bhim says, we will just do that and we'll cooperate with you. So if you see the five Pandavas, the five Pandavas are very different from each other. But just like the five fingers of a palm are very different from each other. But the most interesting thing is if these five fingers stay together, then sometimes they can come together and they can form a punch. And with that punch, if that punch falls on somebody, then that person will be basically hurt. So the five Pandavas, the main advantage is somehow or other they had this art of staying together, and that's why they were very pleased. You know, they caused a lot of pleasure to the Supreme Lord Krishna. And even though they had a lot of differences, somehow they overcame all those differences by focusing on a common goal, that is pleasing Lord Krishna. So Krishna was so happy with them that no matter what happened, the five Pandavas never ever fought with each other. And that's why they considered this a fortune. And Krishna also had a special liking for them. So in our lives also, we can learn from the five Pandavas that we'll have to find some common principles based on which we come together, and then we can also tolerate the differences. Now, tip number two is, more than controlling somebody, we should think of serving somebody. So there is a beautiful quote on the screen which says, time decides who you meet in your life. Your heart decides who you want in your life. But your behavior will decide who will stay in your life. So all of us can think about it from our childhood. Maybe in our school, we had some friends. Then we moved to a college outside our hometown. There we met many friends. In our graduation college, we met many friends. And in our practice, medical practice, now we have some friends. So our friends might have changed. Now, if any one of you is still in touch with your childhood friends, if any one of you is still in touch with your college friends, then you should understand there is something about your behavior that is attractive, and that is why all those friends from your past are still in touch with you. But if you feel every 2 years my friends change, you know what it means? It means there is something about you in your behavior that does not allow old friends to stay in touch with you. So it is लोक आपल्या जीवनात येतात आणि लोक आपल्या जीवनातून जातात, पण त्यातून किती लोक आपल्या सोबत नात्यामध्ये चिटकून राहतील ते आपल्या वागणुकीवर अवलंबून आहे. सो समबडी हू इज व्हेरी फ्रेंडली, समबडी हू इज व्हेरी अंडरस्टँडिंग, समबडी हू अंडरस्टँड्स पीपल आर फ्रॉम डिफरंट ओपिनियन्स अँड ऑल दॅट, बेसिकली दीज पीपल विल बी दोज हू हॅव मेनी फ्रेंड्स. why it's not just a question of being very talkative or being very sweet in your tongue. It's just a question of how your behavior, are you accommodative? Do you see the different varieties not as a sign of misfortune, but as a sign of fortune? So in this way, we understand that it is our behavior which is very important. And in today's time, actually, you know, everything has a controller. The television is controlled, the laptop, we can control, we can play a movie on your laptop, on your phone, you can do thousands of things. You can book your tickets, you can book, you know, you can send an email, you can watch a movie and this and that. So what has happened is, because technology has given us a remote control in our hands, we are so much into controlling by pressing buttons. We feel unknowingly, unconsciously, that we can control people by pressing buttons. So those of us who have people reporting to us, there are people under us and they report to us. Sometimes unknowingly, we also behave like this woman who has a remote control in her hands, that we press buttons and we want people to change. But people are live people. People have emotions. People have their opinions. And you can't just change people. You cannot control people by pressing buttons. We have to understand that if you want people to do something for you, they need encouragement. They need to be supported. And they need to be respected for their opinions and not discouraged for their opinions. So I guess this is something that all of us have to face in the technologically advanced world. Previously, when technology was not so advanced, people understood. When I look at the weather, I don't know. I was talking to somebody today in Baramati, and this person said, "Aajkal roz sandhyakali paus padto hai. Divasbhar paus nasto, par sandhyakali paus asto." And I was speaking to him at around 6 o'clock, and he told me ki aaj pan thoda abhara abhara hai, asa vaatta hai ki aaj pan paus padnar hai. So now he could not tell me for sure whether it's going to rain or it's not going to rain. So he was saying, you know, it's unpredictable. Weather is unpredictable. So before, when technology was not so advanced, actually the weather was unpredictable. People were unpredictable. When you used to send a letter, sometimes a letter would get lost in the post. Now emails don't get lost. So patra lihila hai te yeil ki nahi mahiti nahi. Aaj sandhyakali paus padel ki nahi mahiti nahi. Tashas prakare mi je mhantoy te lokanna patel ki nahi mahit nahi. So that unpredictability was an advantage. Why? Because you were always careful with your words. Mahiti nahi tanna patel ki nahi, mahiti nahi tanna avadel ki nahi. Now with this technology, press of a button. Imagine you start your phone and you press the WhatsApp button and WhatsApp does not open. How irritating it is. How you feel, my phone is such a useless phone. Hey, open, open, WhatsApp open. At the touch of my finger, the app should open. Similarly, when I speak something, people better listen to me. So unknowingly, this controlling mentality has come in our lives. And that's why we have started to see people as toys. आपल्या जीवनातील लोकांना आपण एक खेळणी म्हणून समजतोय. त्यांना चावी भरायची आणि त्यांनी आपल्याप्रमाणे बोलायला पाहिजे, आपल्याप्रमाणे वागायला पाहिजे. सो द राईट थिंग शुड बी, वी शुड लव्ह पीपल अँड वी शुड यूज थिंग्स. But we end up using people and loving things. Lokanshi prem karayla vel nahi urla karan apan ata aplya khelnyanmade khup vyast zalo ahot. Pan adhicha jivanamade jeva khelnya kami hotya teva we used to love people and use things. When Krishna is growing up, at the age of 7, his father Nanda Maharaj hands him over the family business. So sometimes in Baramati, somebody may be a big industrialist or somebody may be a doctor and he has a practice, and when his son grows up, he will hand over his practice to his son. Similarly, Nanda Maharaj, the father of Krishna, what was his family business? His family business was, he had 9 lakh cows. And this 9 lakh cows had unlimited calves, vasara. Taya vasaranchi kaji ghechi jawabdari Shri Krishna na kutlya vayi milali asel koni sangu shakta ka? Andaz laun tumhi sanga. Think about it. Yes, anybody, don't worry, right or wrong. Just give your opinion. ओके आय टेल यू. तीन साडेतीन वर्ष जेव्हा वय होतं तेव्हा श्री कृष्णांना वासरांची काळजी घ्यायला दिली आणि जेव्हा 7 वर्ष वय होतं तेव्हा सर्व गायींची काळजी घ्यायला श्रीकृष्णांना दिली. कॅन यू इमॅजिन दिस? सो वाय आय एम टेलिंग यू दिस टुडे वेन वी टॉक ऑफ हँडिंग ओव्हर द फॅमिली बिझनेस टू द सन, युजली द फॅमिली बिझनेस इज टेकिंग केअर ऑफ सम मशीनरी, टेकिंग केअर ऑफ सम फॅक्टरी. अँड नंद महाराज वेन ही वॉन्ट्स टू गिव्ह फॅमिली बिझनेस टू कृष्णा he started off by giving him responsibility of living beings. The Shri Krishna na 3 varshancha 3.5 varshancha vayamadhe te mhantay ya asankhya vasranchi kaalji ghyachi aahe tula. Vasranchi kaalji ghyachi mhanje kaalji ghyayla lagel ki te kuthe paanyat budayla nahi paijet, kuthe darit jayla nahi paijet, kuthe swatala tras karun nahi ghyayla paijet, kolhe landge yetat kadhi kadhi jangalamadhe tithe yayla nahi paijet. तर वासरांना चरायला घेऊन जायचं, त्यांची काळजी घ्यायची आणि परत त्या सर्व वासरांना घेऊन यायचं. दॅट इज हाऊ कृष्ण वॉज ट्रेन्ड बाय हिज फादर. सो इन ऑर्डर टू टेक केअर ऑफ लिव्हिंग पीपल यू नीड टू बी व्हेरी सेन्सिटिव्ह, यू नीड टू बी व्हेरी केअरफुल. अँड दॅट्स वाय इफ यू लुक ॲट कृष्ण फ्रॉम वन पर्स्पेक्टिव्ह, ही इज द मोस्ट अमेझिंग पर्सन हू लव्ज डिफरंट काइंड्स ऑफ पीपल इन डिफरंट वेज. He is friendly with the simple village people of Vrindavan and he has equal friendship with the kings of Hastinapur, the Pandavas. Rajanshi janchi dosti hai, maitri hai, tyanna eka sadharan gavatlya gavrinishi ani gavri lokanshi maitri karnyasathi kathin jail. Kiwa jar ekada manus hai jo gavamadhe vadhla hai ani gaiinchi kaalji ghetli hai, vasranchi kaalji ghetli hai, to jeva udya raja hoto mathurecha kiwa dwarkecha tyanna tyala te kashta hotil, tyala kathin hai he samajna. But because Shri Krishna was trained in the art of taking care of living beings like calves and cows from his childhood, these are the impressions. That's why Krishna is the most loving person. But that's how his father and that's how his mother trained him. They never trained him in using technology. They trained him in handling living beings. Now, one very interesting thing is you and me are addicted to Facebook. You and me are addicted to all these devices. But Mark Zuckerberg, he is the person who invented Facebook. At his home, his daughter, who's 8-year-old daughter, does not have access to Facebook. Tanni Facebook allow nahi kele swatacha mulila. Te mhantat roz 3 tas bahir aplya gharacha bahir ji bag hai tithe tula jaun khelayche. So he has stopped access to any digital device to his own daughter. The person who has given addiction of Facebook to the entire world, he is not allowing his daughter to access Facebook, and he says तुला जर स्मार्ट बनायचं असेल तर गॅजेट मध्ये तू डोकं नको घालू, तू जिवंत लोकांशी बोल. अँड दॅट्स हाऊ यू ऍक्च्युअली बिकम मॅच्युअर वेन यू टॉक टू लिव्हिंग पीपल अँड यू अंडरस्टँड हाऊ देर आर डिफरंट ओपिनियन्स अँड दिस अँड दॅट. वेर एज वी हॅव बिकम कंट्रोल्ड बाय दिस फेसबुक अँड ऑल दिस गॅजेट्स अँड डिव्हायसेस अँड नाऊ वी आर कॉट अप इन अवर ओन सिच्युएशन. सो वन पर्सन यु नो ही हॅड अ फाईट विथ हिज वाईफ अँड आफ्टर दॅट फाईट ही सेड सॉरी. And the wife thought, oh, I always thought you were wrong. But then he clarified and he said, when I'm saying sorry, it does not mean I accept that I'm wrong. It means I accept that this relationship is more important to me than proving that I'm right. मला हे नातं जास्ती महत्वाचं आहे आणि मी बरोबर आहे की मी चुकलोय हे जास्ती महत्वाचं नाही आहे, म्हणून मी माफी मागतोय. So when we understand this aspect, if we are that person who's expected to say sorry, we'll say sorry immediately. हो ठीक आहे मी चुकलो, पण मी का चुकलो माहित आहे? खरोखर माझ्याकडून चूक झाली की नाही ते महत्वाचं नाही, पण महत्वाचं आहे आज चुकलोय उद्या नाही चुकणार किंवा आज नाही चुकलोय उद्या चुकीन, पण महत्वाचं आहे की हे नातं टिकून ठेवायला पाहिजे. सो दोज हू अंडरस्टँड दिस सेंटेन्स दे विल ऑलवेज टेक अ स्टेप बॅक. सो देर आर पीपल इन दिस वर्ल्ड हू ऑलवेज टेक अ स्टेप फॉरवर्ड, दे आर व्हेरी अग्रेसिव्ह. माझंच खरं, मी जे म्हणतो तेच बरोबर. अँड देर आर ऑलवेज सम पीपल हु आर अंडरस्टँडिंग अँड दे टेक अ स्टेप बॅक. बट वाय डू दे टेक अ स्टेप बॅक? दे आर नॉट अफ्रेड. दे टेक अ स्टेप बॅक टू मेंटेन द रिलेशनशिप. प्रत्येक वेळेस दोन्ही लोकांनी जर नेहमी पाऊल पुढे घेतला तर नेहमी भांडणं होतात आणि त्यामुळे कधीतरी पाऊल मागे घ्यायला पण आपण शिकायला पाहिजे. सो वी ऑल नीड टू एक्सपिरियन्स द जॉय ऑफ गिव्हिंग. All of us have experienced the joy of receiving, but we very rarely experience the joy of giving. I have a small video and then we'll end in 2 minutes, but please stay connected. I want to show you one video. So this is a video. This is one running race that is going on, and there is this person from Great Britain, Alistair Brownlee, and he's running. And we'll just check. But he's getting exhausted. He can't run fast. He's number one, but he's getting exhausted. And he's losing his energy. He can't even stand. आता त्याच्या मागून त्याचा भाऊ आला. सो बोथ आर ब्रदर्स अँड द फर्स्ट पर्सन ही वॉज विनिंग बट ही फेल बॅक अँड दिस नंबर टू ही वेंट अहेड. सो नाव दिस साऊथ आफ्रिकन ही इज नंबर वन अँड दिस टू ब्रदर्स दे आर रनिंग. त्याला तो मदत करतोय धावण्यासाठी. And people are not looking at number one. People are encouraging these two brothers. So this person has won. He's happy. Me jinklo. Jinkla, number one ala. But ata lokancha lakshya kuni kade. आता हे दोन भाऊ येतील. सो दॅट नंबर वन पर्सन कॅनॉट इवन रन अँड अ सेकंड पर्सन ब्रदर जस्ट सी व्हॉट ही इज डूइंग. ही पुश्ड हिज ब्रदर टू नंबर वन. सो यू नो व्हॉट ही कुड हॅव कम नंबर वन बट ही हॅव सो मच लव फॉर हिज ब्रदर दॅट ही पुश्ड हिज ब्रदर टू नंबर वन अँड पीपल वर जस्ट सो ओव्हरवेल्ड अँड दे सेड याला म्हणतात भाऊकी, याला म्हणतात भावा भावाचं प्रेम. की त्यांनी नंबर वन स्वतः आला असता पण त्यांनी ज्या भावाला दम लागला होता, धावायला जमत नव्हतं, त्याला त्यांनी खेचत आणलं आणि शेवटच्या क्षणाला त्याला नंबर वन केलं. सो दिस इज द जॉय ऑफ गिविंग अँड व्हेरी फ्यू पीपल कॅन एक्सपिरियन्स दिस जॉय. अँड आय हॅव आय यु नो पिक्चर ऑन द स्क्रीन. हनुमानजी वेन ही रिटर्न फ्रॉम लंका he found out mother sita and not only found out mother sita he gave her assurance that lord ramchandra will be coming soon and then he also gave a trailer of destruction to ravan and when hanuman ji comes back ram wants to reward him and ram says actually I am in vanvas I don't have any wealth I had one ring and that ring also was given to sita devi ata majhya kade tumhala denyasathi kahi nahiye to te kay mhantat maithe मी तुम्हाला केवळ एक माझी भेट देऊ शकतो. अँड कसली भेट देतात ते, आपण भेटतो ना एकमेकांना, ती भेट देतात. रामचंद्रांची भेट वस्तू काय, त्यांचं प्रेम. सो जस्ट बाय गिविंग सर्व्हिस, जस्ट बाय गिविंग ऑनेस्ट सेवा टू लॉर्ड राम, लॉर्ड रामचंद्र हु इज अनकॉन्करेबल, त्यांना मोठ्यातले मोठे राक्षस कधी जिंकू शकत नाही, त्या रामचंद्रांना त्यांच्या शुद्ध सेवे भावनेमुळे हनुमानजींसारखे एक वानर जिंकतात. अँड राम सेज आय हॅव नथिंग टू गिव्ह यू, द ओनली थिंग दॅट आय कॅन गिव्ह टू यू इज माय एम्ब्रेस. तर तुम्ही जर हनुमान चालीसा वाचला असेल तर हनुमान चालीसामध्ये तुलसीदासजी म्हणतात रघुपती की बहुत बढाई तुम मम प्रिय भरत सम भाई. हनुमानजींच्या या भेटीबद्दल तुलसीदासजी म्हणतात रघुपती राम म्हणाले तू भरतासारखा माझा भाऊ आहेस, तू किती मोठं काम केलं सीता देवींना शोधून काढलंस. सो समटाइम्स यु नो वी कॅन लूज अ बॅटल बट बाय लुझिंग अ बॅटल वी कॅन विन अ वॉर. एक मोठं युद्ध असतं आणि त्या युद्धामध्ये छोटे छोटे प्रसंग असतात. तर कधी कधी हरून जिंकण्यामध्ये खूप महत्व आहे पण कधी कधी आपण नात्यामध्ये छोट्या छोट्या गोष्टीमध्ये जिंकण्याचा हट्ट करतो आणि छोट्या छोट्या गोष्टींमध्ये जिंकण्याचा हट्ट करून आपण त्या व्यक्तीला गमावतो, व्यक्तीला जिंकू शकत नाही. सो समटाइम्स इन अ रिलेशनशिप इट्स व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट टू नो द आर्ट ऑफ लूझिंग अँड व्हेन यू लूज रिपीटेडली देन यू विन द पर्सन. त्या व्यक्तीला कळतं या व्यक्तीला मी प्रिय आहे आणि माझ्याशी प्रत्येक भांडणामध्ये प्रत्येक आर्ग्युमेंटमध्ये जिंकणं जास्ती प्रिय नाहीये. सो विथ दिस वी एंड टू टिप्स अँड देर इज टिप नंबर थ्री, टिप नंबर फोर अँड टिप नंबर फाईव्ह which we'll discuss last in the next lecture because it's already 9:45 and we covered two tips today. So I'll stop here. If somebody has any questions or if somebody has any comments, then we have 5 minutes. If somebody wants to ask something.